अस्सलाम वालेकुम, दिस लेक्चर इज़ फॉर BBA 2. द सब्जेक्ट इज़ प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स. दिस इज़ आवर लेक्चर 5 विच इज़ डिलीवर्ड बाय मिस ज़हरा. टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द मेजरमेंट्स ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दैट वट इज़ इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड एंड वट आर इट्स टाइप्स. Now we will discuss that how we can measure the elasticity of demand. Methods of measurement of elasticity of demand. There are different methods of measurement of elasticity of demand, which are as follow. These four methods are total expenditure method, percentage method, point elasticity of demand method, and arc elasticity of demand. This point elasticity and arc elasticity of demand comes under formula method. Moving forward, we will discuss the total expenditure method firstly. First of all, we need to know that what is total expenditure. Total expenditure is the amount which we get by multiplying price into quantity. That is known as total expenditure as well as total revenue. So we may say that this method is known as total expenditure method or total revenue method or total outlay method. These are different names of this method. Now we will see that total amount spent on a commodity has a close relationship with the elasticity of demand. From the direction of change in total expenditure, we may come to know whether the demand is elastic or inelastic. What we will see? We will see the direction between price and total expenditure. Either they are positively related or they are negatively related. Moving forward, first of all, in this we will discuss the elasticity of demand greater than 1. Initially, we will discuss the previous definition which we have discussed in the previous lecture, that the price elasticity of demand is said to be relatively elastic when a small change in price causes a big change in quantity demanded. But here, as we have to see according to the total expenditure, so we see the relationship. It says that if there is an inverse relationship between price and total expenditure, then the elasticity of demand is greater than 1. Means if price increases, total expenditure decreases, or if price decreases, total expenditure increases. We may clearly see in the table that the price is decreasing and the total expenditure is increasing. How we get the total expenditure column? When we multiply price by quantity, we get the total expenditure column. So we have to learn these prices and quantity. When we learn these prices and quantity, we may easily draw the same table, then that would be easier for us. So what we need to do? We need to look at the relationship between price and total expenditure. Here we may easily see that the price is decreasing and total expenditure is increasing. So there is an inverse relationship. And we have said that if there is an inverse relationship, then we will say that the elasticity of demand is greater than 1. Moving forward, we will discuss the elasticity of demand less than 1. Again, the same definition as we have discussed previously, that price elasticity of demand is said to be relatively inelastic when a big change in price causes a small change in quantity demanded. But here we need to discuss with regard to total expenditure. So if there is a direct relationship between price and total expenditure, then the elasticity of demand is less than 1. If price increases, total expenditure increases, or if price decreases, total expenditure also decreases. So from the table we may clearly see that the price is decreasing. So according to the above statement, total expenditure also should decrease. So we may clearly see from the table that the price is decreasing and the total expenditure is also decreasing. So by seeing this relationship, we will say that the elasticity of demand is less than 1. Moving forward, elasticity of demand is equals to 1. Again, the previous definition that the price elasticity of demand is said to be unitary elastic when there is an equal change in price and quantity demanded. But here we need to focus total expenditure. So if there is no relationship between price and total expenditure, then the elasticity of demand is equals to 1. Means if price increases, total expenditure remains the same, or if price decreases, total expenditure remains the same. So it means that if the total expenditure is changing, if the price is changing, total expenditure should remain the same. We may clearly see from the table that the price is decreasing but total expenditure remains the same, that is 8. So from the table, just looking at the table means that you haven't seen anything beyond the table. By looking just the table, you may easily say that the price is decreasing, total expenditure remains the same. So it means that the elasticity of demand is equal to 1. Next method, percentage method. This is quite easy method. We have previously discussed the formula of elasticity of demand, that is, elasticity of demand is equal to percentage change in quantity demanded over percentage change in price, and the negative sign. This negative sign shows that there is a negative relationship between price and quantity demanded. So easily you may understand, if the numerator is greater than the denominator, the answer would be greater than 2. If numerator is less than the denominator, the answer would be less than 1. And if numerator and denominator are equal, then the answer would be 1. So from this we may clearly define that if percentage change in quantity demanded is greater than percentage change in price, let's suppose 4 is percentage change in quantity demanded and 2 is percentage change in price. So by dividing 4 over 2, we get answer 2. So that we may clearly see that it is greater than 1. Number 2, if percentage change in quantity demanded is less than percentage change in price, then the elasticity of demand is less than 1. So if the percentage change in quantity demanded is 2 and percentage change in price is 4, so the answer is 0.5, which is less than 1. And the last one is, if percentage change in quantity demanded is equal to percentage change in price, then the elasticity of demand is equals to 1. So it means if percentage change in quantity demanded is 2 and percentage change in price is also 2, then the answer would be 1. Moving forward, point elasticity of demand. Easily we may say that the elasticity on a particular point on a demand curve is known as point elasticity, or we may say that if there is a little change in price brings a little or a minute change in quantity demanded, then it is known as point elasticity. The formula of point elasticity of demand is change in Q over Q divided by change in P over P. So by simplifying it, we will see that both of fractions are dividing. When we convert the division sign into multiplication, P will come in the numerator and the delta P will come in the denominator. By simplifying it, we have accumulated the delta's figure on the left hand side of the multiplication and the P over Q figure on the right hand side. So the simple formula is, elasticity is change in Q over change in P into P over Q. Let us look an example. Let's suppose P1 is 10, P2 is 11. So against P1 is Q1, that is 100, and against P2 is Q2, that is 98. By putting the value in the formula, we will get the answer, that is, elasticity is equal to -1.5. So minus sign shows the negative relationship. 1 over 5 will show that what would be the value. So 1 over 5, that becomes 0.2. So 0.2 is less than 1. Last method is arc elasticity. Arc elasticity means elasticity between two distinct points on a demand curve. Or we may say that if there is a significant change in price brings a significant change in quantity demanded, then it is known as arc elasticity. We may measure the arc elasticity of demand by using midpoint formula. What will happen that we are dividing the change in quantity demanded divided by midpoint. What are we doing here? We are dividing change by the midpoint. Change of the quantity demanded divided by the midpoint. Whole divided by change in price over the midpoint. How we get the midpoint? If there are two prices P1 and P2, so we get the midpoint by adding these two prices and divided by 2. So by simplifying this formula, we will get that elasticity is equal to Q2 minus Q1 over Q2 plus Q1 multiplied by P2 plus P1 over P2 minus P1. When we will use it? When there is a big change in price and quantity demanded, then we will use this midpoint formula. And remember that this midpoint formula is more authentic than the point elasticity formula. The example of this one is 2 to 4, 100 to 90. So by putting the value in this, we will get the answer 3 over 19. Again, this is less than 1. But this here, we have used the midpoint formula. This is the answer. And remember that this negative sign shows that there is a negative relationship between price and total. Price and quantity demanded. Now, what are you supposed to do? You have to give me an assignment on total expenditure method. You have to draw all three tables by your own values. Assume the values and look that what is the relationship between price and total expenditure, and show that the elasticity of demand is greater than 1, equal to 1, and is less than 1. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.